Right now, you can track sex offenders in your neighborhood.
But what about the ones who are homeless? We first told you about it in May. 140 a month register as transient, and some of them are ending up in Valley Brook. That's where Wendell Edwards is live tonight. Wendell?
Jessica, take a look at this. It just looks like a bed, a makeshift bed, more than likely for a registered sex offender. They sleep here, or at least did at one point. You can see the pillow, the board, the cushion, the sleeping bag. But therein lies the problem, a big problem in this neighborhood. At the corner of Eastern and 59th, in these woods, is a community on the move.
I mean, they may have made a little mess, but they were still human beings, and they just staying in the tents all they were doing. Just like a neighborhood, you know.
David Green used to sleep here.
When it was 17 degrees, it ain't easy. I got four blankets, but you still notice it.
He's a registered sex offender and says his home literally is now anywhere. Right now, that's here in Valley Brook, in these woods, just a few hundred yards away from a group of businesses. A business like Joe's Addiction, by its name, embracing the transient population. It's a coffee shop / ministry, says owner Jamie Zewalt.
We're aware that there are sex offenders that come here, that hang out here, and we just have said we have to love them the same way that we would love the girls here, that we would love the people that live in the community.
But her neighbors are on the other side. Miss C owns the club next door.
They walk up and down here. They're always bumming from the customers, money, cigarettes. It's hurting everybody's business.
Many just flat don't want them here. It's a community in a tug of war, with those in the middle searching and finding no place to call home. Now, I talked to the police department. They are aware of this transient population, and they are monitoring them as well, making sure that particularly if they are registered sex offenders, they are registering once a week and complying with the law. Reporting live tonight, Wendell Edwards, Eyewitness News 5.
Wendell, thank you. And by law, sex offenders who claim they're homeless must register once a week.